Thanks for passing by. Be sure to subscribe for more engaging content.
Everything is nonsense unless, or until, it's part of your own experience. Even then, it still might be an illusion. Watch, listen, and experience with discretion and perspective.
Today's topic is, does enlightenment lead to a lack of emotions?
Does enlightenment lead to a lack of emotions? Is it a state of detachment, unattachment, non-attachment, apathy, equanimity, emotional neutrality, or any of sorts? Maybe. To describe the state might not be possible with words, or at least not by using the terms I'm familiar with, or anyone else for that matter. People try, but the understanding of each word, of each term, is in the end just a subjective interpretation. That's why there are so many ideologies and philosophies who in actuality speak about the same things, simply using different terms. That's why there is misunderstanding. Is it even possible to describe that which in itself is not defined? The truth lies everywhere and nowhere. When I myself had this question, I asked it this way: does enlightenment lead to apathy? I was genuinely interested. Apathy was the first word I could find in my mind. Emotions, as other people define them for me, are not familiar. For me, it's simply a way of, it is as it is, it has happened, learn, and move on. Control yourself. Be composed. I began at the term apathy, which in turn quickly took me to the word equanimity, a term more commonly attached with the concept of enlightenment. I've understood that I won't be able to explain this state, but simply speak about it as an experience. Let's first try to understand the difference between apathy, equanimity, and detachment. Apathy is usually used as indifference, lack of interest, lack of enthusiasm, lack of concern, unresponsiveness, lack of involvement. Equanimity is defined as mental or emotional stability or composure, especially under tension or strain. Detachment can be understood from its synonyms: objectivity, dispassion, neutrality, lack of bias, fair-mindedness, unselfishness. Then again, the definitions change depending on the language. So what state was I really in? An apathetic state? A detached one? Or was it in a state of equanimity? According to these definitions, it wasn't apathy. Detachment was close, but equanimity was even closer. As consciousness rises, equanimity emerges, it is said. Maybe this is the state I was in. I had better control over my emotions, I didn't lack them. Now then, let's understand how equanimity is part of enlightenment. Before enlightenment, there is often emotional fixating or attachment through positive or negative emotions. For instance, a person could be filled with anger and hate, and thereby be attached to the object of that anger. An enlightened person would not experience that. They are acceptant of what is without judgment, and therefore are non-attached. In the case of being in love and being attached to a person with the emotion of love, an enlightened person would not experience that either. That is not to say they would not love a person, but it is unconditional, non-possessive, and non-controlling. After you become enlightened, you experience a level of emotional detachment. You clearly see that everything, including emotions such as like and dislike, consists of pairs of opposites. Since you can't have one without the other, you can't be overly invested in one side or the other, leading the enlightened being to detachment. This is called balance, simply another name for the same goal that many religions or teachings have. Call it inner peace, if you like, or enlightenment. It is a state of being at peace with yourself and the world around you. The ability to acknowledge and control your emotions is not apathy. It's the byproduct of enlightenment, it's equanimity. In a state of enlightenment, a person won't jump with joy or rage of anger. They maintain equanimity. Though in the end, I've realized that it's all just a game of definitions. Call it whatever you want, but the answer to my question, does enlightenment lead to a lack of emotions? Is no, they're just different.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the content, a like would be very appreciated.